On the 21st day of the month of September, in an early year of a decade not too long before our own, the human race suddenly encountered a deadly threat to its very existence. And this terrifying enemy surfaced, as such enemies often do, in the seemingly most innocent and unlikely of places.
Go downtown.
And without warning, if there was this,
may as well take $50 worth of roses while I'm here.
$50?
$50?
Yes, sir. Right away, sir.
Can you break 100?
100? No. I'm afraid he closed the register for today.
Well, then, I guess I'll have to buy twice as many, won't I?
Twice as many? Twice as many? Audrey, my darling, kindly fetch this gentleman $100 worth of our finest red American beauty roses.
Thank you very much. Yes, sir. That is one strange and interesting pledge.
Well, quick! Don't just stand there. Pull that pledge. What you call it?
And Audrey, too.
Look that Audrey, too, in the window where the passers-by see. My God, I have never believed it. My children, I am taking us all to dinner.
Thank you. genius who has developed a new breed of plant life hitherto unknown on this planet, the Audrey 2. Just one last question, Mr. Cowboy. You feed it anything special?
Special? No, nothing special. It's a secret formula. It's not hard to come by, though.
I see. Well, thanks for coming by.
I'd like to remind our listeners that the Audrey 2 is exclusively on display at Mushroom & Sons, Skip Rock Mars. Open 6 seconds.
WSKID. WSKID.
Imagine if he ever got mad.
So dump the chump.
cooking in a steak. Not fancy like Levittown. Far, far from the urban scape road, where all the houses are so neat and pretty. Cause they all look just alike. And all the same little green walls out back in the same flagstone patio out front. Oh, I dream about it all the time. Just me. Yeah, the toaster. And a little guy who I feel. The matchbox of our room. A fence of real chain link. A grill out on the patio.
Mrs. Sheever.
Mrs. Sheever.
Mrs. Sheever.
Oh, I forgot.
You forgot? How could you forget an order like that? The Sheepers are a most important funereal account. A big enormous family in there. They're dropping off like flies. Oh, I'm telling you, Prelborn, if we lose that business over this, you are finished.
You know, I think Mrs. Bush looks too hard on you sometimes.
Oh, I don't mind. After all, I owe her everything. She took me out of Skid Row Home for Boys when I was just a little tyke and gave me a warm place to sleep under the counter. Nice things to eat like meatloaf and water. Floors to sweep and toilets to clean. And every other Sunday off.
You know, I think you ought to raise expectations for more. I mean, now we're getting successful. Why don't you start off with some new clothes? No offense, but with all the interviews and photo sessions, being put in spammer buttons has to look the part.
I'm a very bad shopper, Audrey. I don't have good taste, like you.
I can help you pick things out.
You could?
Sure.
You'd go shopping with me?
Sure.
You'd be seen in a public place with me?
Sure.
Tonight?
I can't tonight. I've got a date. But maybe another time.
Yeah, I'll pencil you in.
Gee, I bet you got a lot of dates now, huh?
Not dates, exactly. But a lot of garden clubs have been calling.
Gee?
Yeah, asking me to give lectures. Imagine me giving lectures. I never even finished grade school.
Oh, that doesn't matter. You've got a lot of experience.
Yes, some experience. I don't even know what it's like to fly in an airplane.
Me neither.
Or eat a fancy dinner at a place like Howard Johnson's.
Me neither.
Or ride a motorcycle.
Me. Oh, it's no big deal. And besides, it's dangerous.
It is?
Oh, extremely dangerous. Oh, gee, I bet they'll fix my face, my dignity, here in bed.
Excuse me, ladies. Which way to 1313 Skid Row?
I'm afraid that information is going to cost you a dollar.
Hey, no problem. Here you go.
It's right over there. But if you like the thousands of bunnies flocking CDR to two, you better come back tomorrow, man. The shop is closed today.
I'm not here to buy posies, girls. I'm here to pick up my date.
Your date?
You ain't by any chance talking about the girl with the black eye and several other medical conditions?
As a matter of fact... Ladies, ladies, please. I'm friendly. Truce. Patch ya. Johnson, not Southside.
Why don't you get out of here, Southside?
The last thing I need is more.
My kind is a very nice kind, ladies. I'm not a monster.
What else would you call it?
I would call it a... I would call it an occupational hazard.
Say what?
You see, ladies, my line of work requires a certain fascination with human pain and suffering. This stuff is great. And I'll be explaining. When I was younger, the bad is here. My mama knows funny things I hear. Like shooting puppies with a baby gun. And boys and yuppies are well done. I find pussy cat fast in here. That's what my mama said.
What did she say?
She said, my boy, I think something. You find a way to make you mad. You'll be a jackass. Some kind of new species or something.
Well, that's what they tell me. Now, if you don't mind, I'm not really supposed to let him.
Oh, don't worry, Seymour. This is my boyfriend. Oh, or Carmella.
Hey. I'll tell you something, kid. You say you raised this thing, right?
Right.
Well, I sure as hell wouldn't be keeping it under a barrel in a skid row dump like this. This avocado here could be your ticket to the stars. Bring it to any flower shop in town and name your price. Hell, somebody make you a goddamn pint to get their hands on this.
Well, I don't care. I'm happy here.
Seymour's very warm.
Somebody talking to you?
Excuse me.
Excuse me, what?
Just the way to
speak up. That's better. I'm telling you, kid, this thing's a big green gold mine. Get your ass out of this dump and take the bank with you. Mushnick Skid Row Florist. Ha! It's like a joke. You hear me talking?
I hear you.
He hears him. Shouldn't we be leaving now? Excuse me!
Excuse me, what?
Excuse me,
Doctor! Gotta train him. Hey, sir. Well, my bike's outside, double parked. Do you think about what I said, Scout? I mean it. You think about it.
I'll think about it.
He'll think about it.
You do that. Okay, Audrey. You got the handcuffs?
They're right in my bed.
Well, let's go.
Be my own doctor boy. I never liked you much before, but can't you?
her son! I'm her son! Sudden changes surround me. The lady love came and found me. Thanks a million for making the magic you do. Thanks to you, sweet Petunia. Mushnick's taking a junior. And someday when I own this whole shop, I'll remember I owe it to you. Who cares if I've been a little on the anemic side these past few days? A little lightheadedness, a few dizzy spells. It's been worth it, old pal. Oh, I'm starving. I'm gonna run out to Schmendrick's and get a bite to eat. I'll see you in the morning. Oh boy. Oh, maybe I can squeeze a little out of this hand, but.
Feed me!
I beg your pardon.
Feed me!
Jeremy, you talk! You opened up your thing and you said.
Feed me, Crownborn! Feed me now!
Well, I can't.
I'm starving!
Oh, I know, but you keep mailing
me. I need some food!
I know, but you can't get blood from
me.
Look, what do you want me to do? Slit my wrists? Look, how about I run down to the corner shop and pick you up two nice chopped sirloins?
Must be blood.
Timmy, that's disgusting.
Must be fresh.
I don't want to hear this.
Feed me.
Does it have to be human?
Feed me.
Well, does it have to be body?
Feed me.
Where am I supposed to get?
Feed me, Seymour. Feed me all night long. You can feed me, Seymour. Feed me all night long. 'Cause if you feed me, Seymour.
Help me get it out, will you?
Well...
Well, he says, well, see, well, I don't think you understand. Don't be fooled if I should get the...